Hello, everybody out there.
I like to make simple things for kind of beginners, practical. Now, this one I'm using Rhino 4. You can use it in Rhino 5 or probably Rhino 6, whatever. It's just basic tools. What the subject is, I have a you might get a stone that you buy from a gem show, or you know, you cut a stone or a cabochon freeform, and you know, normally you could make it in fabricating it, but this time we're going to make it in using a rhino. I'm just going to make a simple pendant and show you how I did it. First of all, I measured my stone. And then on a white sheet of paper, I drew a straight line and put my stone on there. And I just show you the measurements so you can see it. Now over here, I put the measurements 3130. And then from here, I did a line from both sides, from midpoint. And I split that in two, 1635. So I drew a line half of that distance, both sides. But I got my layout lines on that point. Let's concentrate on the picture now. We got to get this picture up to this size, or whatever we're making. So let's crop this photo a little bit. Just kind of crop it. Just kind of eyeballing it, all right? Let's trim it out from here and go there. Now let's take this, let's move it. Put my snap on. Let's move it. I'll try and go a little slower for you guys. Now I have my end on. Let's go from end on, and let's just snap it to a grid. Alright, good enough for right now. Well, here's the thing. Think about my stone, as you'll notice it's not symmetrical at the bottom here. So what we want to do is I drew my line. Now I can adjust my picture a little bit. Let's get this lined up a little bit straighter. And I'll turn my snap off. And then and if you want to get that up to that line close enough there. So that is in line with the line that I drew on the picture. Got that lined up. I don't need that anymore. Oops. There. Now what we gotta do is draw our line right here. Duplicate that. So what I did find here, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put a point. I just wanna put a point. Now these are approximates, and the one thing I will say that you have to, when you mill this out, roll it, print it, and then you cast the piece, the actual piece of jewelry, you deal with shrinkage and you deal with the fitting. So this will fit you close. I milled it out and I'll show you. It'll get you close, and you might have to do a little bit of hand work, but all in all, it was very nice. I'm going to take the surface here though, and let's lock it. And I found that to do this curve, what seemed to work the best for me was I did a conic. On the curve here, I did a conic. Let's click that conic, and I'm just going to go from the point here and here. I see the, it's a little thing you gotta play with, but you gotta pull it out a little bit. Okay, and let's just see how we get, how close we get. Now that's pretty good. All right. Then we've got to draw this curve. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. Now I want to put a point in the midpoint. All right, see, on the midpoint of this curve. And then I'm going to draw a line from the mid, ortho line, and let's get it up to about there. So now we have that. Now we've got to draw that curve. We're going to draw one curve on this side to that point, and one curve on that side. Excuse me, because this is not symmetrical, we can't mirror it. The stone is not symmetrical. So, let's put your old snap, or your snap on, and make sure you snap it, and you pick it up at the end. And, you know, you just kind of go to town there. And you draw it. And you can adjust it. And you might want to even turn on your right here. Hit your shift and your ortho. And get that straight there. Now, if you want, you can turn on your control points there a little bit and tweak it. And play with it the more you want. And then we got to draw a line on the other side. Okay, now we got the line drawn on this side too. Let's grab those lines. Let's join them up. And then one closed curve. Very good. Now we're going to use that curve and we're going to trim out. Let's get rid of the background there. Locked, okay, so it's locked. Gotta trim that one, trim out, so I gotta unlock it. Now let's go back and trim. There we go. Okay, now we've got to get this up to our size that we're gonna need. So let's move it now from this midpoint to our 0, 0, 0 point. Alright. Yeah, I have my F1 key set up as a hotkey for my 000 button. Alright, so now we're going to scale this two-dimensional up to our point there. So I want to take the curved line there. And I want to grab the surface. And let me see if we got everything. Yeah. So we got that. And let me take one more look. Alright. And we're going to scale it. Don't matter. 2, 3, 3D, 2D. I'm going to go 2D. You need to go from end. End. To end. Now, I do want to check, I think I made the size of my line wrong. I want to check one thing here. 15.3. Okay. Let me do my scale just a minute here. Oops. Okay, sorry about that. The reason I didn't turn out right, my line, top line, I didn't have it the right length. Remember that length is 3130, and I didn't have it. I had it at 16. So anyway, we're going to back to scaling this now. We're going to grab that and go back to here, the end, and we're going to take it at the end We're going to go all the way up to here. Now, I just want to check one thing, see how close we got here. Pretty close. You know, it's pretty close. Now, we can adjust that in the end. We'll do something in the end. Okay, so now we got that scale. Let's hide this. And let's just, you know, for the sake of it, I'm going to join these and hide them. Just for fun, let me put a point here. No, I don't need that line. Oh, that line. Well, what we're going to do now, we're going to make our bezel for this piece. Let me do one thing here. Let me change that to another layer. Put it on the purple layer. And we're going to hide the purple layer. I'm going to lock that. And I'm going to grab those. And I'm going to hide them once again. And then I'll unlock it. Ready to go. So anyway, we're going to make our bezel for this. Let's maybe go with the take our curve and we'll offset it right here. Let's just go 0.75. Well, let's go 1 millimeter. And we're going to keep it, keep it smooth. Alright. Now those two curves will be for our bezel. And then we're going to have another strip in here that's going to be about, let's go with 3 millimeter. So I want to offset that another. This time I want to offset it 1.5 mil. Okay. And we've got that now. So let's make our bezel. The stone is approximately 3 millimeters tall at the edge. So I'm going to grab this one, and I'm going to extrude it. And I'll go up. We'll go up like 3. How about 3.5? For sake of discussion. Good. Now I'm going to grab this curve. And I'm going to drag it up 0.5 millimeter. And I'm going to take the curve and I'm going to extrude it past our original surface there. Now I'm going to Boolean difference. Let's see what we've got going here. Let me grab this thing. That surface. I'll bring it straight up. There we go. Remember, it's just a surface. So let me try one thing here. Okay, we've got our bezel made for the outside. Now let's do our little trim piece here. What I do, I'm going to pipe it. I'm going to pipe it right there with a 1.5 diameter. Tell you what, let me make it just a little bit bigger. I'm going to go 1.2 diameter. I'm sorry. No, it's not bigger. I'm gonna try this again. Sorry, guys. And we're gonna make it 1.65. And I'll go ahead and hit enter. And there we have that. Now, one thing I want to show you that bugs me sometimes. The seam right here, I know when you design a piece, I don't like that seam there. So here's something you can do if you want to move your seams. You go to Surface Tools, and right here, Adjust Close Surface Seam. So I go here, and wherever I throw this, that seam will be. Maybe I'll put it up there. And now you see the seam is there now. That's something about me. Okay, now we want to trim this out a little bit. We'll do a draw me a line. Okay, let's go with make a straight line here, snap on. So we're and we'll use this and we'll use it as a wire cut. We'll get our line, we'll get our surface. And see how that one turned yellow on top? That's, we want to flip it. The yellow is the one that's getting deleted. Alright. The wire cut left us a nice solid back. Alright. Now about this piece, if you want, you can always scale it up or down. Let's scale it down. You want to scale it up. Do what you want to do. Alright, now the other thing I want to show you is, see right now we've got a solid back in there. And if you want to make it more of a open back, we can maybe grab one of these curves. Let's see if we can offset a curve again. We'll take that curve. And we can go to 2 point. What do we want to do? Okay. And then we're going to let me show you one thing real quick. See, I can't see my line under there because I have this surface above the line. We'll highlight that. We'll go here and we'll go to Material. Go to Transparency and see what we get here. There we can kind of see it for right now. So we can, at least we can do our modeling. Take that line and then I'm going to extrude it on both sides this time, both sides. And then we will let me just hide this so I can see. And then we hide that. Wait, let me look. Okay, undo. Alright, now we do a bouillon difference. Here. Here. Now you see we have a lip in there. That our stone would rest on. Alright. Let me show that. Let me grab my curves for right now. And we can cut them. We don't need them. Let's go back to this piece. Let's get it back to what was that on a yep. Let's see. Could probably just type it, I'm sure of that. Oops. Let's see. There we are. Sorry about that delay. All right, we'll do one more thing here, and we will just, now you can bevel it, or you can put a, do it any way you want. We'll just do it here, a little chamfer. See what it looks like. All right. Now what I had did, I done did this. Flip my model over there a little bit, and then yeah, as a pendant you would make your, you can make your bail and do whatever you want to do. So you've got your kind of like a free form now. All right, here's one I did model out. I didn't do the bale or anything like this, but I did carve it. I did mill it. And let me see here. Let's see if I can get that unlocked. I did mill it, so it was a pretty good fit. That is the actual stone in there. So again, what I wanted to just show you, the kind of a way to design something using a picture. And I took the picture off my iPhone. All right, thanks a lot, guys.